Oh, so you?
Well, no, I have a wife. I have a wife. I have a kid. So, yeah, let's not go there. Hello, 저희 구독자분들이 120명이 넘었어요.
120?
120. What is 120?
120.
Good. 그리고 저희 정말 재미없는 저희의 영상 중에 하나가 4만 6천 명 뷰가 넘었어요. 너무나 감사합니다. On count of three. Let's take a bow. One, two, three. 감사합니다.
감사합니다.
네. 120명의 구독자분들 너무나 감사합니다. 오늘 저희가 이야기 나눠볼 거는요, 대한민국의 치안에 대해서 이야기 나눠볼 거예요. 치안 is public safety, but there's another word that sounds very similar to that with totally different meaning.
Okay.
치안.
치안.
Right. We're going to be talking about 치안, which is public safety.
치안.
치안.
치안. 치안.
But don't get it mixed up with 치안.
치안.
치안 means either pervert or sex offender.
Oh, so you.
Well, no, I have a wife. I have a wife. I have a kid. So, yeah, let's not go there. So, very sensitive.
Yeah.
치안, 치안.
치안, 치안.
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 Yeah, that's the 치안 is
치안?
the public safety.
치안.
Right.
Okay.
Right. It's just you got to be very.
Yeah.
마크가 한국에서 지내면서 대한민국의 치안 부분에 대해서 어떻게 생각하는지 어떤 경험이 있었는지 한번 물어볼게요. What is your thoughts or experience in Korea, living in Korea? Do you think it's safe? Do you think it's not safe? How was it?
My thinking that Korea is really safe.
Yeah, me too.
That's much more safer than France, actually.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I think so. An example, you are in the coffee shop.
Mm-hmm. And coffee shop?
Yeah, oh. Coffee shop. And I leave my wallet on the table and my mm-hmm. phone.
Mm-hmm. What's that, Mark?
Because you are Americans. But in Korea, I go to toilet. I've done it a few times. So in my experience, then I will not recommend to the people to do that.
Okay,
but in my experience, I left it on the table. Mm. When I left for like 5 minutes, mm-hmm. I came back, everything was here.
Really?
Yeah, and I'm living here for a while now and nothing happened to me.
Wow.
Even the people leave the laptop, they leave the phone, they leave everything on the table, nothing will happen.
Wow.
I don't know if that's because the other people will check on it, they will take a look on it, or because that's just safe. But my thinking that because Korea is safe.
Yeah, I have to agree with you on that, at least. I also think Korea is very safe. 마크가 커피숍에서 이렇게 여러 번 이렇게 경험해 봤대요. 잠깐 화장실 다녀오는 동안 뭐 랩탑을 한국말로 랩탑, Korean people call it what? 노트북, 컴퓨터. 컴퓨터 이렇게 놓고 가거나 지갑 놓고 가거나 키체인 놓고 가거나 뭐 전화기 놓고 가거나 그리고 뭐 2, 3분 이제 볼일 보고 돌아와도 그대로 있는 거를 여러 번 경험했는데 프랑스에서는 상상할 수 없는 일이다 라고 말하면서 한국이 굉장히 안전하다고 얘기를 해 주었어요. 저도 대한민국은 굉장히 안전한 국가라고 생각해요. 어느 곳이나 언제나 안전하다라는 말씀은 아니고요. 내가 안전을 지키기 위해서 내 surrounding, 내 주변, 내 환경을 이렇게 체크할 수 있는 정도만 sensitivity가 있다면 굉장히 안전하게 지낼 수 있는 곳이라고 생각해요. Alright, so New York, where I'm from, New York.
Mm-hmm.
I have to say New York is very safe. People tend to think that New York is not safe.
Okay.
But, you know, I've lived there for more than 10 years, right?
So you will say that New York is safer than Seoul, for example?
Safer than Seoul? Maybe not, but it's very safe. It's still very safe. Yeah. What do you mean?
I don't believe. You always hear the story about the people got...
Right, mugged, raped, killed.
Killed.
Sure, you get killed sometimes. So what? Everybody dies, right?
This is crazy. I will say everything is... maybe some places are more safe, actually.
Yes, yes, yes.
Maybe.
Yes, yes, yes. 맞아, 맞아, 맞아.
Manhattan?
Manhattan. I mean, not only Manhattan. Even in Manhattan, some parts can be dangerous. But as long as you know where to go, as long as you know the surroundings.
Yeah, but if you're a foreigner or 외국인 like us in Korea, and you go to New York and you don't know the places, do you think that's safe? Like to go everywhere and to...
To everywhere?
Like once,
I wouldn't recommend it.
Once, I remember I was in LA, Los Angeles, and I didn't know the place I was going. And I arrived in the place with the people surrounding me was actually homeless. And it seems to be like a place where you can buy the drugs or something. And I was feeling unsafe because the people were looking at me like, who is it? Who is this guy? Who is this white guy here?
Right.
I was like, shit, what I'm doing here? Why I'm here? So I don't know about New York. I've never been there, but...
Very true. It could be dangerous for foreigners or people who are not too familiar with the town. Yeah, it could get dangerous. Not just New York, but pretty much anywhere in America.
So could you do that, actually leave your wallet on the table in
New York?
Yeah.
No, man.
Your phone, crazy. Maybe.
No, what not even your phone. Yeah. I would never do that in New York. Yeah. So, yeah, in that term, yeah, Seoul is safer. Seoul is safer than New York.
Even if you, you are going out in the in the pub or in the club and you get drunk. And you are just walking by yourself, really, totally drunk. Nothing will happen to you.
In New York?
No, in Korea? In Seoul, yeah.
Right, right, you'll be fine. And so is in New York. In New York, you'll be safe. Yeah,
really?
You'll be safe.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, unless you go, you enter the dark areas. Yeah. Unless you go there, you'll be safe. 뉴욕에서도 뉴욕은 굉장히 그 안전한 곳이라고 저는 인지하는데 마크는 아니라고 부정하고 있어요. 근데 마크의 말도 일리가 있어요. 저는 뉴욕에서 지내면서 뭐 위험하다 못 느끼고 지냈었거든요. 근데 마크의 말이 그러니까 그거는 제가 뉴욕 사람이니까 거기서 어디를 가면 안 되고 어디 가면 괜찮고 뭐 그런 것들을 알기 때문에 가능한 일이다. 근데 그 말이 정답이에요. 정말 뉴욕은 재밌는 게 골목 하나 차이로 부촌과 빈민촌이 갈리는 곳들이 있어요. 그래서 길 하나 잘못 건너면 총기를 소지한 사람들에게 내가 노출될 수 있는 상황이 발생할 수도 있는 곳이 뉴욕이긴 해요. 근데 관광객이라도 그런데 근처로만 가지 않는다면 그런 실수조차 할 가능성을 그 아예 처음부터 지우고 완전히 안전한 곳들만 찾아다닌다면 뉴욕은 굉장히 안전하고 즐거운 곳이라고 생각해요. How's it in France?
In France in general or in Paris or whatever?
Yeah, whatever. Yeah.
Okay. I will not qualify France as a safe country. My thinking.
The reason
I don't think that's safe. Because, example, you leave your wallet or you leave your phone on the table, there will be the people coming inside the coffee.
Coffee shop?
Yeah, coffee shop. And they will invent like the solution to take your to take your stuff. You are here or you are not here. So they will come, you know, with a piece of paper, put it in front of you. And then when you don't give attention to this, then your phone will be gone. Or even if you go to toilet, you leave like 1 or 2 euros on the table, you leave your coat, maybe it will disappear. You don't know, not everywhere, but... This is unsafe. Same if you walk at night, you have to know where you are going. Like in Paris or in my city, in some places it will be dangerous. You could fall on a group of people who will take your phone. They will take even maybe your shoes. Or
these group of people are like teenagers?
No, like adults.
Really? Yeah. So it's their occupation.
I don't know if that's their occupation, but they are making money by stealing the phone by. Stealing the shoes, by stealing whatever. It's not like this everywhere in France, but in some places it will be more dangerous. Even Paris, like you go in the subway, you have to be careful about your wallet, you have to be careful about your phone, everything, because if you don't give attention, your bag will be cut. Your phone will not be here. Your wallet, it's happened to especially Asian tourists. The target will be the Japanese, Korean, Chinese, because they have a lot of cash on them,
right?
And they are coming for holidays, but after one day they don't have anything because, like, this is a special group of people. Like, actually, we have a problem with East of Europe with the Romanian people. That's true. And even one of my friends went to Paris, and she went in the subway. Two young girls followed them inside the subway, and they went inside the same subway as her and follow her for about 30 minutes, which is really scary. This will not happen in Seoul. In Seoul, you can sleep in the subway. Nothing will happen to you.
Right.
Nothing.
Right.
So, in my opinion, France is not that safe.
Compared to Korea.
Compared to Korea. It's so safe.
그 프랑스에서 커피숍에 지갑이나 폰을 이렇게 커피숍에서 놓고 자리를 잠시 떠나는 거는 말할 것도 없이 내가 이 자리에 앉아 있는데도 이거를 도난당할 수가 있대요. 그 정도로 그러니까 내 주변 환경에 더 신경을 쓰고 살아야 된다는 이야기죠. 그러니까 한국 서울에 비해서 그리고 프랑스의 모든 곳이 그렇다는 이야기도 절대로 아니고요. 어떤 곳에선 그럴 수도 있다라는 말이고요. 밤에나 나 혹은 낮에도 어느 골목 같은 데는 피해야 되는 곳들이 발생할 수 있고 여러 가지 이야기를 마크가 해줬는데 그런 것들을 토대로 마크 생각에는 한국이 프랑스보다 안전하다라고 느껴진다라고 말을 했고요. I don't know about you, but whenever there's tension between South Korea and North Korea, I get a phone call. I get phone calls from my family members, my friends back in States, asking, what are you doing there? What are you doing in South Korea? Come back. And I tell them, it's totally safe.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
That's, you know, the TV abroad in France, in US, they will report that, oh, there's so much tension between North Korea and South Korea. But South Koreans know about this. They are living with this for
many years,
so they know about this. But as a foreigner, you know, your family will be worried. What is happening now? What?
Yeah.
Why there is conflict? But my thinking that it's actually safe.
I think so.
There's a lot of talking happening, but still safe.
Right.
I will still feel more safe in Korea with this happening beside, you know, nearby South Korea, than staying in France. Seriously.
Why? Why? Because of the terrorism?
The feeling. I like the feeling to walk in the street without worrying about my phone or without thinking about what can happen to me if I go in this street. You know, I don't have to worry about this in Korea. People are nice, talk to me. The places are safe.
Right.
In France, you have to think, oh, what's going to happen to me if I go this way?
Oh, nothing.
There is a group of people here.
Right.
Should I go this way? Is it safe?
Right. We don't think about that in Korea. Right. Not saying all the Koreans are angels. Not saying that at all. But for the most part, it's very safe. 한국과 남한 간의 그 컨플릭트가 뭐 이런 신경 그런 뉴스들이 많이 이제 일어날 때 사회적 이슈로 이렇게 부각될 때 미국으로부터 혹은 프랑스로부터 친구나 가족들에게 전화가 와요. 도대체 남한의 그 대한민국에서 뭐 하고 있냐. 근데 사실 여기서 살고 지내면은 그거에 대한 공포감이 여러분은 어떠실지 모르겠지만 저는 못 느끼겠거든요. 그냥 하루하루를 그냥 열심히 일하면서 사는 건데 외국에 있는 사람들에겐 그게 굉장히 그 불안 요소가 되더라고요. 그러니까 내가 사랑하는 사람이 대한민국에서 지내는 게 불안할 수 있겠더라고요. 근데 또 저도 뭐 그런 불안감, 전쟁에 대한 그런 불안감에 100% 자유롭지는 못해요. 미국 대사관에 제가 그 메일링 리스트, 이메일 리스트에 등록해 놨거든요. 그게 해주는 게 뭐냐면 전쟁이 발생할 것 같으면 US 엠버시에서 저에게 연락이 와요. 그래서 최소 몇 분이라도 더, 조금이라도 더 준비할 수 있도록, 대피를 할 수 있도록, 대처를 할 수 있도록 그런 메일링 리스트가 있어서 거기에 등록되어 있는 상태예요. So I guess I have a little bit of fear. Yeah, I'm not totally free from it. But still, I'm still here, right?
Yeah.
I feel safe.
I'm not scared about this. I mean, if it should happen, it will happen anyway. But now I feel more safe.
Let's hope it doesn't happen though. Yeah.
I feel safe here in Korea and I love Korea, so that's okay.
Yeah, me too. That's a good word to know, right? I love Korea. Do you know how to say that in Korean?
한국에 사랑해? 아니야? 대한민국 사랑해?
Yeah, 대한민국 사랑해. Yeah, that was perfect. Let's say that together. On count of three?
Mm-hmm.
One, two, three.
대한민국 사랑해.